deliverance again.
Amen.
Amen.
Dear friends, we are here in King's Kingdom Ministry and the presence of God to unite Deborah and Robert in marriage. The Bible teaches that marriage is a permanent relationship of a man and a woman. Freely and total commitment to each other in companionship for life. Our Lord also declares that for this reason, a man shall leave his father and shall unite with his wife in the building of a home, and both of them shall become one flesh. We already saw Mark already present. Wonderful mom. Amen. So we already know who presents this woman. Who presents this woman to this man? Amen. Praise God. Amen. May the blessings of God rest upon you. We do have a scriptural reading that we do believe is necessary for this wonderful celebration of marriage.
Then Jehovah God said, "It is not good for the man to continue to be alone. I am going to make a helper for him as a complement of him." Now Jehovah God had been forming from the ground every wild animal of the field and every flying creature of the heavens. And he began bringing them to the man to see what he would call each one. And whatever the man would call each living creature, that became its name. So the man named all the domestic animals and the flying creatures of the heavens and every wild animal of the field. But for man, there was no helper as a complement of him. So Jehovah God caused the man to fall into a deep sleep. And while he was sleeping, he took one of his ribs and then closed up the flesh over its place. And Jehovah God built the rib that had taken from the man into a woman, and he brought her to the man. Then the man said, "This is a last bone of my bones."
We are excited about this celebration between Robert and Deborah. I have a word from the Lord that I will be giving. This word is from the book of 1 Corinthians chapter 13. The home is built upon love and with the virtue to last forever. 1 Corinthians, Paul's first epistle to the church. He said, "Love is patient, love is kind, love is not jealous, love is not boastful, love is not arrogant, love is not rude." It says, love does not insist on its own ways. I believe we talked about that during our meetings. Amen. It's not irritable. Love is not resentful. Love is always joyful. Rejoice in all things. Rejoice when things are wrong. Love beareth all things. Believe all things. Hope all things. But where love never ends, but where there is faith and hope, among this, including love, among this three, the greatest is love. Marriage is a companionship which involves mutual commitment and responsibility. You will both share in this responsibility. I believe we spoke about that during our counseling. During the time I counsel with you. you both share in joyfulness. I really did not like everything here because they talk about sorrow. But I want to say my prophecy for you is that you will continuously see better days ahead of you. There will be no sorrow in this marriage. I want to exhort you to on two things. One, let the Bible be your guide in your home. Let it be your guide. And also, be committed to the kingdom of God. With these two forces, I believe you will end up building up a glorious home that heaven, God, will be so proud of. Let us pray. O Lord of life and love, bestow the grace upon this marriage and seal this commitment of thy children with love. Amen. Robert, will you take Deborah to be your wife? Will you commit yourself to her in happiness, in making her happy, in self-fulfillment as a person, and to her usefulness in the kingdom of God? Will you promise to love and honor and trust and serve her in sickness and in health, in adversity, in prosperity, and to be true and loyal to her as long as you both shall live? Deborah, do you take Robert to be your husband? Will you commit yourself to his happiness and the self-fulfillment as a person, and his usefulness in the kingdom? And do you promise to love, honor, and to trust and to serve him in sickness and in health, in adversaries, in prosperity, and to be true and loyal to him as long as you both shall live? Amen. I thought somebody would put his hand together for Jesus. This time we are going to be given the ring. Father, we bless this ring. And we decree that just as this ring has circled, so there will be an everlasting love. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, this ring is declared blessed. Amen. Amen. I, Robert, I pledge and give to you, Deborah, this ring as my love to you, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. I, Deborah, we give you this ring as a pledge of my love and my commitment to you. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Entreat me not to leave you or to return from you. For where you go, I will go. And where you lodge, I will lodge. Your people shall be my people. And your God shall be my God. Since they have made this commitment before God in King's Kingdom Ministry, by the authority of God and the laws of the state, I declare Robert and Deborah husband and wife. And we all bow our heads. Our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debt as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thy is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
Amen.
The Lord bless you. The Lord keep you. May the face of the Lord shine upon you. In Jesus' mighty name. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. And Mrs. Robert Mack. Congratulations, 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 congratulations. Congratulations. Family, congratulations.
Daughter Erica and her husband Kevin. And that's the sisters and connections. And then the next is Deborah's children. Where's Mark, who is the oldest? He's the first grandchild and the first nephew. And I hadn't seen him in so long. I was just so full of emotion. My heart was just so open. I hadn't seen him in so long. And Dwayne, where are you? Oh, here's Dwayne. He's 11. And his wife, Jackie. And Tacharaya, the daughter. And little Charlie over there. Just
chilling. She's up.
And who have I missed? And Joy. Joy is the daughter, and she's just not here yet with Zion. And okay. Now, the problem is, I don't know all the names of your family. You're going to help me? Oh, hey, nephew.
Sons are off on away their directions.
And they all sent their love.
Amen.
And I just want you to know I love you. I'm really happy. I'm so happy that you're here.
And I wanted to, this just was a misstep on my part. We have a cousin here, which is my mother's niece. Great, great niece.
You tell it all.
I just want to introduce my daughter, my cousins, her cousins, which is Teresa, who's recently passed. And I wanted to use her daughter,
mm-hmm.
Denise.
That's so my family.
Okay.
Okay.
Okay. And my long time friend, Deborha. I am excited today. This was spoken of. She called it. She believed it, and now she has received it.
Amen.
And I just thank God on behalf of the Morning Office,
you
the show consistency.
Huh? You gotta do something.
We are just excited and happy to see the manifestation of God taking place. As you say, if you ask for it, and if you speak it, it shall be so. So it is so, and we thank God for meeting Robert. So welcome to Sister Shopping and Sisters, and Brother Shopping and Welcome. And family, shop and family, and we just bless you, and we just thank God for you, and may heaven shine upon you, and what God has joined together.
Want some wine?
It says, let no man put asunder, and that includes the both of you. So don't you two separate what God has joined.
Amen.
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 Okay, anyone else? Oh.
Later.
Yeah. I'm a brother. Ken. How's everybody?
Alright.
Alright, the Bible says seek ye first the kingdom of God and righteousness, and all of these other things shall be added. So he blessed me with a new sister-in-law, his nephews.
You are
the
Thank you. Set her trap. Going to cut right now. Try to be.
Get everybody. Okay.